All right, everybody has a pretzel? Excellent. I'm going to ask you some questions, and I want you to answer. Now remember, we're trying to persuade our audience that they need to buy these pretzels, okay? So you can go ahead and pick it up if you want to and look at it. But here's our first question. Use your imagination, be creative, and tell me, what is this word right here?
Look.
I want to know, what does this pretzel look like to you? What does it look like to you, Manjot?
Knot.
A knot. Very good. Okay, it looks like a knot. What else, Jared?
A heart.
Good job. That's a good positive thing. That would persuade me. Tyler?
Two eyes and a nose.
Two eyes and a nose. So that would be a?
Person.
A person or a face. Good job. A person. Or a face. Excellent. What else does it look like? Anybody else? Can you use your imagination? Andrew, what does it look like to you?
It looks like a steering wheel.
A steering wheel. All right. Excellent. Steering wheel. Taylor.
Food.
Food. What kind of food? Just.
Anything.
Something you just want to crunch on, doesn't it? I know what you mean. All right, any other ideas? Skylar.
One of those Disney hats with Mickey's ears.
Mickey Mouse. It does look like Mickey Mouse, doesn't it? Ryan.
If you put it upside down, it looks like Spider-Man eyes.
It looks like Spider-Man eyes? Ooh, a Spider-Man mask. Good job. How about if I put mask on the board? Can I do that? Because we'll call it a mask. You're exactly right. It looks like a Spider-Man mask. What else? Taylor?
An owl.
An owl. Very good. It looks like an owl's face. All right, so we have some ideas of what this looks like. And these are all pretty positive things. So we want to persuade our audience that this is a pretty creative pretzel, okay? All right, let's see. Now, the next question I want to ask is, what does the pretzel feel like when you touch it, Natalia?
Hard.
Hard, good. Israel.
Crunchy.
Crunchy. It feels crunchy. Especially once you break it, it feels really crunchy, huh? Crunchy. Good. What else? Jared?
Bumpy.
Bumpy. Excellent. All right. Sierra.
Smooth.
Smooth. All right. Now, you know what? We have a very good little couple of words here. Bumpy. And smooth. Bumpy and smooth. Hot, cold, up, down, little, big. What kind of words are bumpy and smooth? Skylar?
Opposite.
Opposites. Those two words are opposites. Good job. So what we've just discovered is that one product is opposite. It's got two different things. It's smooth and bumpy. How is that possible? How is that possible? Look at your pretzel. How can it be both smooth and bumpy? Jared?
They baked it with salt.
Because there's places there with salt and then places without salt. So it's smooth and bumpy. Good job, you guys. Okay, Andrew?
Jagged.
Jagged. It feels jagged. Good word. You all are coming up with some great adjectives to describe how this feels. Good job. Tyler?
It feels rough.
Rough. Good job. Hey, do we have one more? Karina.
It feels soft when you break it.
Soft when you break it. Now let's think about the word soft for a minute. Soft is kind of like cotton or a pillow. So does it feel soft or does it feel smooth?
Smooth.
Yes, yeah, smooth is probably the word we're looking for. We use soft a lot to describe smooth. That's for sure. I know I do. Bernardo, do you have one more?
Feels funny.
Feels funny. All right, you know what? We can put funny on the board. It feels funny. All right, so we're well on our way to writing our script for our commercial. We've come up with some great ways to describe our product to our viewers. Now, I need you all to tell me, how does this product, what is that word?
Taste.
I see a whole lot of hands going up, but how can you actually know the answer to that question unless you've done your homework? Eat the pretzel and then tell me how it tastes. How does this pretzel taste, Sierra?
Salty.
Salty, excellent. Definitely in a good way, salty. Andrew, how does it taste?
It tastes kind of like bread.
Yeah, it tastes like bread. I like bread. That's a good thing. Okay, Desiree.
It's good.
It tastes good. Excellent. Abel.
Delicious.
Delicious. Great word. Now we need to come up with a name for our pretzels. Okay, a name for our pretzels. Taylor?
Salty pretzels.
Salty pretzels. Israel?
Tasty pretzels.
Tasty pretzels. Good job. Bernardo?
Crunchy.
Crunchy pretzels. Good job. Andrew?
Jagged.
Jagged pretzels. Skylar?
Golden.
Golden pretzels. Good. Manjot?
Tasty and crunchy pretzels.
Tasty and crunchy pretzels. And Gabby?
Salty stuff.
Salty stuff. Ooh, all those are really good ideas. And let's see, where can we buy these pretzels? Can you come up with the name of a store maybe that you've never heard of? Something creative, something interesting. Make it up. Manjot?
The pretzel hardware.
Pretzel hardware store. Ooh, that's kind of fun.
Pretzel bowl.
The pretzel bowl. Ooh, I like that one. Let's go with that one. You can buy it. So these are the names of our pretzel, the Tasty Stuff pretzels. You can buy it, buy them at the pretzel bowl. Now, how much should a bag of pretzels cost? Taylor?
$6.
$6? Those better be some pretty good pretzels. Israel?
For a big bag of pretzels, yeah.
$5. $5? Skylar, what do you think?
$1.99.
See, now that's probably about what I'd pay for a bag of pretzels. Thank you so much for volunteering. Come on up here. All right, so here we go. We have a shawl here for Grandma. And what else do we have for Grandma? Look at our beautiful Grandma. There we go. So we have our family. We have Mom, Dad, Grandma, Grandpa, and we have Miss Pretzel Bowl here. So you can move back here just a tad. Okay, and let's see. Now, the rest of you are going to be the kids in the family. All right? So let's see. How about if we go ahead and have all the daughters come over here by Grandma, so, and all the sons come on over here by Grandpa. Come on over here, Skylar. We want you to squeeze in. There we go. Now remember, your job is to persuade the audience that they have to have these pretzels because they're the best pretzels in the land.